Welcome back. Thanks for your company today. Well, there are fresh revelations this morning on the cancellation of Victoria's Commonwealth Games, with an Andrews-backed report warning the Premier of budget blowouts back in 2019. Joining us to discuss today's headlines is 4BC's Sofie Formica in Brisbane and Liberal Senator Jane Hume, who will join us momentarily in Melbourne. But Sofie, let's come to you first. Now, despite recommendations to host the Games in 2034, the Andrews government pushed ahead for 2026. Does this suggest it was doomed from the start?
Yeah, potentially, Sarah. It does look like that, doesn't it? I think at this point what we can see here is that there are plenty of questions that are being asked and not a lot of answers that are forthcoming. And it does, there are some parallels, obviously, to what's going on here in the preparation, being 9 years away from Brisbane hosting 2032. And I'm not suggesting that the Commonwealth Games are anything like the Olympics. We know that they're very different beasts. But when it comes to costings, decisions that are made behind closed doors, I think it's only fair that now people are wondering how it was that he waited until this point to come forward to say, look, this might not be looking like it's going to turn out the way that we'd anticipated. It was something that he took into the last election. Yeah. It worked very well from a campaign perspective. Now that things have got a little bit tough, we're pulling the pin. Well, I think one of the questions a lot of people are asking is, did you not look at Plan B? If you knew that there was going to be a cost blowout associated with it being a regional Games, what would it have looked like if it had gone back to being more centralised? And then, you know, cancelling a contract is going to cost money. What does that look like? I don't think, again, that the Premier is going to be able to hide behind any sort of commercial and confidence clause. I think the people of Victoria are going to want to know what the costs are that are going to be associated with deciding now that the Games won't go ahead in Victoria.
Yeah, Sophie, I think you're right making the point there about more questions than answers at the moment. And this is the problem, you know. I think when you agree to take on a big event like this, you do need to have some transparency, and promising the regions one thing and then not delivering and now trying to make up for it. I mean, surely that doesn't wash with the public.
No, it doesn't. But then on the other hand, Sarah, and you would know this, you know, you've got lots of friends and family in Victoria. Yeah. There are many Victorians who are really happy about the decision that it's not going ahead. So, you know, one thing's happening politically and behind closed doors and between the Commonwealth Games Organising Committee and the Victorian government. Yet on the ground, we know that plenty of Victorians are saying it's a great thing that the Games aren't going to be happening. You know, anecdotally, I was just speaking to somebody last night who used to live in Melbourne and is back there now for business, and said they have never seen the homelessness situation the way that it is now on the streets of Melbourne. So we know that there are challenges right across the country and that Melbourne and Victoria are not immune to them. I think the one thing is going to be the future accountability. Yep. If Dan Andrews is saying we're not going to spend the money on the Games because it needs to be spent elsewhere, there will now need to be movement there. And I really hope that addressing some of those issues, and in particular those that are sleeping rough, will be on the top of the to-do list.
No, you're absolutely right there, Sophie, about the public's accepting that perhaps the Games isn't the best idea. But the issue, I think, Jane, will bring you in, is that people, while they agree the cost was too great to bear, aren't happy with the process that's caused, you know, all of this angst and unrest, because people are left in the lurch. I mean, there are businesses out there, athletes, of course, who have been impacted by this. If they knew, if the government knew that there was likely to be a cost blowout, you know, a year ago, why did they push through with this?
People are scratching their heads, Sarah, and wondering how we signed up for this in the first place. When we knew we were already going to be the most indebted state, our debt in Victoria is bigger than Queensland, New South Wales and Tasmania combined. And it was already the case before we signed up to the Games. Moreover, all of these rural and regional communities have been promised so much in the way of infrastructure and also an opportunity to showcase themselves on a global stage. And that's all fallen by the wayside. So I think you've just got to scratch your head and wonder how on earth these promises got made with a straight face. They looked people in the eye, and it was prior to an election, let's not forget. They looked people in the eye and they said, we're going to deliver this. They've failed to deliver it. And this is because of the economic mismanagement of this government. And Sophie's right, heads should roll over this. You know, in any other state, there would be a minister that was responsible for this debacle and they would resign. But that's not going to happen in Victoria. And this is going to be made out to be the economically responsible thing to do. Well, the economically responsible thing to do would be to have not done it in the first place, because it's going to cost billions to get out of.
Yeah, and I guess the cost of how much it actually will be to get out is yet to be known.
Well, Victorian Premier Daniel Andrews has refused to apologise to businesses impacted by his decision to scrap the 2026 Commonwealth Games. Thousands of regional businesses are already out of pocket, including 70-year-old small business owner Simon Kemp. He joins us now from Footscray in Melbourne. Simon, good morning to you. Nice to be with you. You own a conference communications business. How has the cancellation affected you?
It's just horrible, Carl. This was promised to us by the state government. This will pull you out of the COVID recession. And we build a lot of hope to get a lot of work out of events such as these, because there's so many connected events to it. We did so much in Brisbane, and now to lose this and to hear the Premier say, I make no apology, it's just pretty awful, actually. It was an awful day yesterday.
Yeah, I feel really genuinely sorry for you. I was listening to the 3AW all day yesterday, and it was call after call after call. Mm. How much money have you lost in all of this?
Well, it's the working capital that's not there. Mm. We came out of COVID with nothing, and if it hadn't been for our own private super, I just don't think our business would be open. Not when we plundered it, but we had something to live on. Mm. But now I really don't know. To order new equipment from overseas, you have to put money up front. You have to pay before it leaves overseas. And because of microprocessor shortages around the world, you have to order a long time in advance. So now, you know, I've got this order on its way. So now I'm going to have to find a way of jettisoning.
Oh, mate. Look, you run a small business and Dan runs a big business. How effectively? I'll let others argue about that. But big decisions need to be made, but it's the way you make those decisions. He's made no apology to athletes or businesses out of this. How does that make you feel?
It's the worst kind of a kick in the guts. You only have your future. This is a husband and wife business. Our technicians have gone interstate. They work right through COVID. Here we had nothing. So on top of that, I'm worried that we go back to Kane Kerner, where we had money owing for over 240 days by the state government.
Oh, mate, I genuinely feel sorry for you and all the businesses affected. We appreciate you being on the show today and best of luck moving forward. Thank you.
Thanks, Carl.
More fuel has been added to the Commonwealth Games fire with revelations this morning that Victoria Premier Daniel Andrews knew the budget would blow out. Christina Hearn is in Melbourne covering this for us this morning. Chris, looks like you need a fire this morning. Is it chilly there?
Just a little bit chilly, Carl, but nothing we can't handle in Victoria. Do you know what we definitely can't handle in Victoria? It emerges is a Commonwealth Games, because there are fresh revelations this morning about what the Andrews government knew. And reportedly, in 2019, the government funded a report into the feasibility of staging a regional Commonwealth Games. And that report recommended hosting the Games in 2034. According to The Australian, that report cited various cost risks, such as the lack of suitable stadiums, distances that would be having to be travelled, and also staffing, and the reason why more time would be needed. Apparently, the 2034 task force was blindsided when the Andrews government announced that Victoria would be hosting the 2026 Games. Now, on Tuesday, the Victorian Premier said, well, Games chiefs actually came to Victoria and basically begged us to help out and host those earlier Games, but those claims have been since rubbished by the Commonwealth Games Association. Meanwhile, as the future of the 2026 Games hangs in the balance, Scotland and Christchurch have emerged as potential host cities. Might be a little warmer there, Carl.
Indeed, Chris. Thank you.